From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Police are looking for an alleged rapist, Sav, and need your help in locating him. Take a look at this composite sketch right here. A woman says this man attacked her, sexually assaulted her, and then robbed her after her car got stuck on some ice. The 41-year-old woman told police that she was on her way home and driving down a rural road in Sebago early Saturday morning at around 12:30 a.m. when a passing motorist stopped. She thought he was going to help her, but instead, she said, he attacked her. The woman said she was left on the side of the road, and her attacker also grabbed money from inside the car before taking off.
We do believe her story to be true. That's why we're going to chase down every lead that we possibly can, every little piece of evidence that we can put into any database, like I had mentioned before, that we find this horrific in our community.
Police say the woman was treated for injuries and released from the hospital. They plan to input the DNA recovered into the database. Meanwhile, the victim said that her attacker was driving a gray or dark-colored GMC full-size pickup truck with a Ski-Doo sticker on the back window. The truck was carrying a snowmobile trailer that may have had two snowmobiles on it, one red, the other yellow. The truck also had New Hampshire license plates. And if you have any information about this case, you're asked to please contact the Cumberland County Sheriff's Department. While checking in for a flight, the jet pool will now be different for passengers. But the Transportation Security Administration hopes that new measures will lead to improved safety and efficiency. This morning in Portland, TSA and JetPort officials unveiled three new advanced imaging technology machines. The system screens passengers for metallic and non-metallic threats without physical contact. Machines use automated software to create a computer-generated outline of the person on an attached computer monitor. However, the process is not mandatory. Southwest Airlines has announced it will be coming to the Portland International Jetport. Southwest acquired AirTran last year, and the Dallas-based carrier announced recently the list of AirTran airports it will continue to serve, and the Jetport made the cut. AirTran currently averages about two flights to Baltimore daily. Paul Bradbury, the Jetport director, says that he believes those flights will continue when the merger is complete. Bradbury is not sure when Southwest officially makes the changeover, but he says it will not be until later 2013. Well, we're keeping an eye on the price of Super Bowl tickets tonight, and even with the game nearly 2 weeks away, they are going for a bundle, no surprise. At Tickets Unlimited in Westbrook, owner Dan McCarthy tells us the cheapest seats are already selling on the secondary market for more than, get this, $3,000. And some of the better seats as high as $17,000. McCarthy, who has access to nearly 2,500 Super Bowl tickets, says that he believes a combination of the matchup and the team's markets will keep the prices high.
I think the hype of the rematch from the Patriots losing the heartbreak the last time, New York market is always going to drive the price.
Well, even if you find a ticket, McCarthy says that finding a place to stay in or around Indianapolis could be just as difficult and just as expensive. By the way, the face value of this year's Super Bowl ticket is between $800 and $1,200. Thanks for joining us here. We'll be right back.